Hello everyone, and welcome to Atoms and Sporks. And in this video, I want to answer one simple question. If you're in a brightly lit room and you turn off the light switch, pretty much instantaneously the room seems to go dark. But where did all the light go? Though, we'll go a bit further than that. Well, the short answer here is that it's all absorbed by the room. When light is incident on material, like a wall or a table or whatever, there are only three things that can happen. Either it transmits through the material, it's reflected by the material, or it's absorbed by the material. As to which happens with what fraction, that's entirely dependent on the material. A wall made out of paper will transmit quite a bit of light, but a wall of cement or drywall will not. A wall painted white will reflect a lot more than one that is painted black, and so on. But the nitty-gritty numbers really don't matter that much, because light is ludicrously fast. Let's say I'm in a room that's about 10 meters across, and that room is painted white with a paint that, let's just say, reflects about 90% of all visible light. Well, that still means that it absorbs 10% of light each time light reflects off it. And thus, after one bounce, there will only be 90% of the light left. After two bounces, there will be 81%. After three, there will be 71%. And after just seven bounces, there will only be 47%. So after seven bounces, already half of it is absorbed. And after, let's say, like 50 bounces, there's only half of 1% of the original light left. And light travels 300 million meters in a second. That means it makes it across our 10-meter room in 30 nanoseconds. And if we assume that reflection is instantaneous, that means it will only take one microsecond to bounce 50 times and be almost 100% absorbed. And, you know, to the human eye, a microsecond is basically instantaneously, and that's why a room seems to instantly go dark. But then, that pretty naturally leads to a question. What if I was in a mirrored room? Well, in reality, a typical mirror is only like 99% reflective, which may seem like a lot, but like even with 1% absorption, it would just take like 15 microseconds to have as much absorption as the 10% case. But what if we did have perfect mirrors? You know, true 100% reflectivity. What then? Well, then things would get weird, as is often the case when you consider impossible ideals in physics. For one, if we truly had 100% reflectivity in that room, then that room would quickly explode. Why? Because of radiation pressure. Something we've done a whole video on before on this channel is the simple fact that light has momentum. When you illuminate something, that light exerts force on it. Now, it's very, very small. On something like a sunny day, sunlight is only exerting a pushing force in like the nanonewtons, which is why we don't notice it, but it is there. And if we truly imagine a room with perfect reflection, that force is going to add up really fast. You see, let's say our light bulb emits one quanta of light, you know, a photon, which then reflects off our mirrored wall, and it imparts a momentum on it as its direction changes. Well, at that moment, if the light's been on for a while, that's not the only photon hitting the wall. There will also be a photon arriving that was emitted from the light 75 nanoseconds ago, and has already bounced off the back wall once and is coming back for a second reflection. And there will also be one that was emitted 135 nanoseconds ago, that has since done two round trips and is now back, and one that was emitted 195 nanoseconds ago and that's back from its third round trip, and so on. And even if that light's only been on for a few seconds, you'd still have like a billionfold or so multiplication of the radiation pressure, if none of this light is actually being absorbed. And this, by the way, is actually a proposed plan of how to send small probes into space. You can use the momentum of light, like a big earthbound laser, to launch like a small cube probe into like another star system. But the power requirements are ludicrously high. But if you instead imagine something like an orbital mirror platform that allowed successive bounces and thus a kind of multiplication of the radiation pressure, the numbers, well, I mean, they're still actually like ludicrously high, but they are better. And that's actually what we're seeing in this video here. There's a mirror, so you're getting a multiplication due to multiple bounces. But obviously, as this radiation pressure multiplies towards infinity, something's going to give. But let's say the room doesn't explode, but instead imagine the walls of the room can move freely and expand with this pushing of light. And imagine in this situation that I turned off the light. What would happen? Well, the room would actually go dark again, even though no light is being absorbed. And that's because light, with its momentum, must obey the conservation of momentum. As it reflects off the walls and sends the walls into motion, in other words, giving some of its momentum to the walls, it loses momentum. Now, for most things, like a tennis ball or whatever, when they lose momentum, that means they slow down. But light can't do that. Light always has to go the speed of light. Rather, when light loses momentum, that means its frequency or color shifts towards lower energies. It gets redshifted. And as this continues to happen, with each bounce, as it pushes the wall more and more, our light will eventually redshift out of the visible range and eventually into infinitely long radio waves with negligible energy. And our room goes dark again. So recapping, when you turn off a light switch, even in a mirrored room, all that light will have reflected like a bajillion times in a fraction of a second and be totally absorbed in what seems like an instant. If we put on our laws of physics breaking cap and imagine what would happen if we had a room made with mathematically perfect mirrors, well then the radiation or light pressure in that room actually tends towards infinity the longer the light's on. However, if we allow the walls of that room to move freely, then I actually get a dark room again. This time, because even though the light is never absorbed, it is robbed of energy with every reflection, and thus redshifts into nothingness, which is kind of cool. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe if you did, and have a good one.